Okay, so that was the steam railway. I got there kind of too late to do the interchange with the island line. It'd have been a bit tight, I would have just been not on the train like the whole time, either the steam train or the island line train. So if you want to do that, you need to get the first or second train really. So now I thought I'd go to Ventnor, which is another 39, about half an hour away from where I am now. There, like you could do with a visit to the local trichologist, someone who makes wigs or hair implant. Looks like it could do with a straw implant, that one. Must be really expensive, quite expensive to look after those. Because most of them, you probably can't change them to a slate roof, because they tend to be listed, I think. There's a lot of old thatched cottages. Fun. When I ride, and I'm not talking to you lot, my millions of subscribers, I usually like to sing. It soothes, helps me focus. I can't sing on YouTube, can I? Because I'll get a copyright strike, probably. In Ventnor. I don't know what I'm going to do here. I'm just going to look around. I just sit and look at the sea. Oh, I see the sea. Wow, it's very hilly. Esplanade, indicators, apparently not, the Longshoreman's Museum, now there's something, isn't there? Oh, Jesus is Lord, apparently. Holy moly, oh dear. This is a bit steep, isn't it? Not liking this. Goodness. Closed. We're leaving Ventnor now. Okay, so that was, well, that wasn't Ventnor, that was my visit to Ventnor. Yeah. I'm sure it's lovely. I'm sure it's lovely up in the town. I mean, look at that pavilion up there. That's lovely, but I don't really want to be changing in and out of my gear. I like to find somewhere where I could just sit near the bike and take things in. And that wasn't really happening there. This apparently is called the Zigzag Road for some reason. Seems a bit, I don't know, just looks a bit sorry for itself. I mean, ideally when you, I mean, I'm in here a couple of nights and I'm camping. I guess ideally if you want to explore somewhere, you might, say in a B&B or something, and leave, so you've got somewhere to leave your stuff. Well, I haven't got all my stuff with me, obviously, like the tent and my cooking set and stuff and my clothes, so I haven't brought that with me. But things like cameras and stuff like that, you know, I'm not going to leave it in a tent in the middle of a field which has got a footpath going through it. So yeah, so I picked another town and then I put it into the sat nav and it suggested places in that town. And the town I put in there was Bembridge, which is the other side of, so imagine the Isle of Wight, the south coast. Bembridge is at the very east end of it, so it's kind of pointing eastwards. And then you've got, not necessarily in this order, you've got Sandown and Shanklin and possibly Newport, I don't know, I think. And then Ventnor, which is where I am. So now I'm kind of heading east. I don't know if I'll pass through Sandown, whether this road actually goes through Sandown or what. But as it does, I do know is that it's a 60 mile an hour road and this guy in front is doing 30. So instead of talking to you, I should be looking for opportunities, shouldn't I? Or 10% up. Was it 10% down? Oh, down by the looks of it. Ooh. 10% down on a big old 180 curve. And we've got some traffic lights. Oh, here we are in Sandown. Shanklin, sorry. Now, Shanklin and Sandown, I probably shouldn't say this, but they're kind of the same place, really. I'm sure they weren't originally. But there's no space in between them on the map. Oh, it's a proper thatch roof, isn't it? That one. That one wasn't in need of a transplant. I don't know if you even saw it, because we're on super wide. So I think this is Shanklin. Welcome to the lake. I think the lake is a bit in between Shanklin and Sandown, I think. I haven't actually seen a lake here, so. Well, this is exciting, isn't it? I don't know how long that diversion is going to be there, but let's see the positive side, shall we? You get to see more of Sandown than you thought you would. Bicycle for sale. See, I wouldn't have seen that if I wanted to buy a bicycle. Well, there was one there, it wasn't that old. Not fairly new, actually. So, there we go. That would be an opportunity lost if I wanted to buy a bicycle, which I don't. Open road. I think that is the River Yar. It is. Now that river, Yarmouth, is right at the other side of the island, so I'm assuming that's where the Yar empties out. And that is like Yarmouth. Kind of diagonally opposite to where we are now across the island, so that goes a long way before it reaches the sea. must say, there's some lovely roads here. If I had more time, like a week or something, it'd be nice to really explore the island. Road-wise. Bembridge, I mean, and everything is so close. Low flying aircraft. No stopping. Well, that must be good at low. Is that the vehicles or the aircraft that aren't allowed to stop? Going. Use lay-by. What is lay-by? I'm guessing so. Off-road.
Gonna go to the top, see you up there. Okay, this is the top floor of the windmill. I guess that's where all the stuff. Down there, to the next floor down. Huge cogs. I guess they're brought up in sacks. Oh, I'm not going to say. But there's a trapdoor there. There's a winch there. There's a bin there. So. Wow. Oh, mind your head. Miller's must have been short. So it's the next floor down. Some stuff.
Oh, and then we can see the sails. Giant canvas.
So this is next floor down. This is, I guess, the first floor. Belts and things, police. We're not getting seasick. Pretty sure that electric light isn't original.